Hey guys and girls, this is Modine here. This is a quick short video description of a third version of this Stanley Sortmaster do-it-yourself Bluetooth boombox. I'm going to go through it very quickly, just point out some of the major components and differences compared to the last two builds. You can simply look at my video channel and see a description of the first version and second version. This is version 3. This is based off of four lithium ion batteries, 3.7 volts each. The previous two were based off a 12 volt lead acid battery. In this case here, I have the same voltmeter on the handle there, and then I have an on-off switch on the red button there, charging jack on the left, 3.5 millimeter stereo input, and then I have the three knobs. The one on the right is a volume, middle is treble, and left is bass for the BBE XR1075. So I'm just going to open it up. I'm using the same exact speakers from these Philips LCD TV speakers. So the speakers are the same, the box is the same, the Bluetooth receiver version 4.0 with aptX is the same as the first two previous builds, but everything else is a bit different. In the back, behind the Bluetooth receiver is a 25 watt D-class amp in stereo. It's made by Shure Electronics. I have four batteries in series, 3.7 or 4.2 times 4 is 16.8. And also have the BBE XR1075. So everything's running off these four batteries. The voltage requirements of the BBE are anywhere from, I believe, 9 to 24 volts. Voltage requirements for the Shure Bluetooth Electronics, it says 9 to 15 volts, as you can see right about there. But I've had it, you know, working, this is the second or third version, working with 16.8 volts, so that's not an issue whatsoever. It works perfectly fine there. And then the voltage requirements for the 25 watt D-class amp, I believe anywhere from about 14 to 27 volts. So those are the voltage requirements for the three major components, electronics. Signal comes from your phone through this antenna, Bluetooth receiver, and it goes out to directly to the input of the BBE sound processor. This is the input, 3.5 millimeter. I have elected to solder all the way in the back. You can see my other videos describing that. Output is always coming out of the RCAs, and those are also soldered. And those go directly to the input of the 25 watt Shure D-class amp. Of course, from there it comes out for left channel over here, and then right channel goes all the way around, snaking all the way over here. Everything's all soldered. And then the 3.5 millimeter stereo input jack also goes in parallel, as you can see, coming out of the Bluetooth receiver. The bottom line is it goes to the BBE processor for processing first, and then also comes out to the same line over here. So the signal comes from either the Bluetooth or direct line in. So that's it. I've also, you know, put hot glued a nickel on the back of the passive radiators. As you can see on previous videos, I've cut these down, modified them so they'll fit inside this box. This version is a bit lighter, simply because it does not have the 12 volt lead acid battery. The two other versions have the LaPie 20 watt amp, which had, you know, decent sound, good tone control, is very clean. This one also has a bit more power, and it simply gets a lot louder too. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm going to play a demo tune, and that'll be it. Thanks, bye.
obviously. iPhone mic is approximately 3 feet away from this do-it-yourself Bluetooth boombox.